Hare Krishna. Sensual pleasure touts itself as free and then takes toll forever. Often in the world today, there are so many pleasures that seem to be so easily, freely available. Sensual pleasures, especially the pleasure of seeing attractive sensual forms, seems to be available free today on the internet. And just go to some sites and we can surf and enjoy as much as we want. But even if it touts itself as free, it is not free. Why? Because once we indulge in sense pleasure, an invisible rope is formed between us and that particular sense object. Just like some drug dealers might give some drugs free as a taster for some gullible young people. Now, once they take the drug, they get hooked to it. And once they are hooked to it, they will not be given free. They will have to pay for it. And even if somehow they get free, still they are spending so much time, energy, losing their health, losing their mental balance. And eventually, they lose their moral compass. They lose their spiritual purpose and they end up wasting their lives. So any kind of sensual indulgence, even if it promises itself to be free, it's not free because it takes a toll on our consciousness. It consumes our consciousness. It enslaves us. We become puppets who are pulled toward that sense object and then we are controlled by those who are providing us that sense object. And this toll can go on forever. The Bhagavad-Gita cautions us about this in 3.39 when it says, Avritam jnanametena jnanino nitya vairina kamarupena kaunteya dushpurena nalena cha. So kamarupena, self-destructive desires such as kama, what is the character Krishna says? Nitya vairina. They are like eternal enemies. Avritam jnanam. They cover our knowledge. And they continue deluding us for a whole lifetime. If we do not wish to be deluded, then we need to resist them. And they will take toll forever unless we stand up and fight against them. Unless we decide that I am no longer going to indulge in them, we will be extorted. So therefore, it is not so easy once they have got a hold on our consciousness to say no to them also. So by knowing that there are no free lunches in the world and there are no free pleasures in the world, that sensual pleasure, that it appears free is simply a part of its grand illusion to entrap us. Knowing that it will entrap us sooner or later, we don't let ourselves get allured by sensual pleasures, but we turn toward Krishna, connect with Him and rejoice lasting spiritual pleasure therein. Thank you. Hare Krishna.